Men and women running in the Boston Marathon is a very common sight.
It was so unbelievable to start the Boston Marathon, all excited. We're going to Mecca, we're having the biggest race of my life, to the 2 mile mark, when all of a sudden the race director jumped off the press truck and attacked me and tried to pull off my bib numbers and throw me out of the race because I was a woman. It was a life-changing experience.
But up until Syracuse University student Catherine Switzer ran the entire 26.2 mile race back in 1967. No woman had officially entered and run the marathon.
The act of finishing the race was the most important thing in my life. Not being attacked, but finishing it and showing the world that a woman could actually run 26 miles, 385 yards.
Switzer took her inspirational story of how she broke down gender barriers to Auburn High School to share with neighbors of all ages.
Many people coming out to see Catherine Switzer say she has been an inspiration to them in the past and continues to inspire them right now in the present.
I'm a runner, and so she inspires me to run and to continue to run, and she inspires me to inspire others to run. My daughter.
Switzer says for centuries, sports were started with men in mind, speed, power, and strength. But this running icon has predictions for the long-term future of sports across the board, saying they will be oriented more to female strengths discovered in the years after her run, like endurance, flexibility, and balance.
My coach and I, training for the Boston Marathon, realized that the longer the distance got, the better I got, and that indeed now we have found that women actually have more in stamina and endurance than men. The problem is we're just discovering events and creating events that enhance those capabilities.
Stories from the past, which are just as relevant today. Reporting from Auburn, I'm Alex Rosilla.